times when I was asleep. And you know how, like, when we talk about the Holy Spirit has, like, a still small voice? I was, the devil, why I wonder, was trying to act like he was the still small voice. Came up and was in my ear and was like, and you're not getting anything.
I remember you told me that. That scared me.
I was like, look, dear, remember I said you don't have to be like, devil in the name of Jesus? I was like, look here, devil. I said, first of all, the blood of Jesus against you. You have no business talking to me at this level. I said, how dare you try to talk to me, come at me like you the spirit of God, all nice and quiet and trying to mock him. I'm like, I said, not only am I getting everything that I asked for, but I'm getting more. On that note, I bind you and I cast you out of my house. Seriously. I remember, this is how much God has your back. Now, there's going to be times when you're outside of the will of God, you're going to be in danger. Now, God is also in the business of looking after dumb folk, too. You know, stupid folk. I got this, Jesus. He's like, here we go. But God knows what we can handle. Certain things we bring on ourselves. And people try to sit there and blame God. No, if God is giving you information, the devil's not gonna tell you it's depression, it's suicide. No, trying to do stuff to get you distracted so you won't be focused on who it is, so you can zoom in on who it is or what it is. And even if you don't know, everything that is not of God, every spirit that is not of God, I renounce you in the name of Jesus. I cast you out of my life. I cast you out of my mind. In the name of Jesus. And I bind you. Leave me in the name of Jesus. You have to be that bold. I mean, I heard what your mom said. But I don't want them, like, locking you up or taking you to the principal's office. And they're like, well, Jerry, what's wrong? I'll be like, he is talking to you. Now, in this world, the unbeliever don't understand. That's what I'm saying. Throughout your day, even if you don't sense anything negative, you know, still God, pray. I thank you for keeping me. I thank you for answering my prayer. I thank you, God, for allowing me to love school again. I thank you for taking the stresses and the pressures off of me for school. Help it be better than when I first started, before I even was like excited for school. Lord, I thank you for renewing my relationship with you and my desire for school. Whatever God drops in your heart to say. Seriously. You have to speak. You have to. Now, I know about those feelings of, you know, God, if you can just let this mountain just fall on me. Because I can't take this no more. No, seriously. You feel like you may feel on the inside or in your mind the pressure so strong that you can't focus, you can't think. You know, you feel your emotions is going crazy. You feel like you're turning to somebody that you aren't. You can't just let it happen and be like, help. I mean, it's real. It's real. I was at my lowest of low. And the enemy had the nerve to say, now call me Lord. after my brain about to split in half, but I ain't calling you Lord. I can understand there's gonna be times where you feel like that you can't even cannot pray for yourself, but while you can, why can't you? And it's like when things happen, don't just talk about them. Just like when your Aunt Crystal was talking about